Hi there, my name is Dan. You and me are going to learn how to create our full screen background video website, both the video creation and building the website. Now there are loads of videos here like this one on my channel, but if you want more, check out my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. Hey, welcome to this video. This video we're going to cover something called motion blur. Motion blur is your secret sauce, okay? Easing was cool, blurring is better, okay? It just adds that believability because we've got some static type, it had that kind of PowerPointy feel to it. We added some easing to give it a little bit of kind of like real world, real life motion. And motion blur is the kind of like next step to kind of adding a bit of slickness to it. And it just means that when it's moving, it's blurring like it does in kind of real life. When something's running really fast in front of you, it kind of blurs when it's moving, okay? Because we can't kind of get a really crisp image of it. It happens the same on film with live action. We're gonna fake it with static text, okay? There's no reason it should blur other than it looks cool. Okay, to do it, it's pretty easy. And there's two things you need to turn on. You need to turn this button on here, okay? This particular button turns it on globally. So if you click on this, if you hover above it, watch, it says enables motion blur on all layers with motion blur switch set. All right, so to preview it, it's spacebar. You can see no motion blur. We've turned it on, but nothing happens. Okay, so that's to turn it on globally. That says, I am prepared to do motion blur to the layers that you tell me. And that's what we do. We've got two layers here. I'm gonna twirl this little arrow up to make it look nice and clean. You can see here, I can add motion blur. See the same little icon here to the squares underneath. So I can add it to this one. I can add it to this one underneath, but it doesn't move. So it could be on or off. It doesn't matter because it's not moving. Anything you've animated with keyframes, you can turn it on. So you gotta turn it on twice there globally and turn that one off afterwards. And now watch. All right, let's get it back to the beginning. Be prepared. Easing plus motion blur equals coolness. And ready, and go down. Just kind of blurs while it's moving. Yes, you might be thinking, that's not as cool as Dan makes out. I love it. And to extreme it up a little bit, because it's not really moving that fast. Watch this, it's kind of zoom. See, even I was like a tiny bit underwhelmed. What I'm gonna do is twirl down this. Find my keyframes, and to speed it up, right, it's taking 2 seconds, or nearly 2 seconds to get across here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna say, you, my friend, take 1 second. It's gonna move a lot faster, because it's got shorter distance to cross. Watch this. Now we're talking motion blur. Okay, I'm gonna shrink this one up as well, so it's about half a second. Then, there we go, motion blur. Okay, with it off, PowerPointy, with it on, super sexy. Nice. Okay, so motion blur is on for this. Why would you have two buttons for it? It was a bit silly. It means that say you've got 100 layers here, and don't be afraid if you do get up to like 50 layers in After Effects, totally part of it. If you've got lots of things animating around, that's what happens. So what you can do, what motion blur does is it stresses the machine out a little bit, trying to blur it. So what you can do is, and say you're not really worried about the kind of look of it, you're just kind of like technically doing some stuff and you're sick of it taking forever, you can say globally, even though we're on for all of the layers, maybe on for 50 of the 100, you can turn it off globally just while you're previewing, just to slow stuff down. Okay, you just gotta make sure you turn it back on when you're finished to get that lovely smooth blurriness. All right, that's how to add motion blur, and that's like the second step in the two-step process of making things look really slick in After Effects. We're gonna cover a bunch more stuff, but when you're teaching yourself and you're doing kind of basic type animation, turn those two on, bit of easing, bit of motion blur, and you will look awesome. All right, see you in the next video.